Next time you eat a pineapple, this one is almost gone already, don't throw away the peel or the leaves. Instead, we are going to prepare some tepache. So first, you need to wash this peel really good. With soap and everything. Give it a really good wash. Yeah, like that. And then all these peels, you just place them in a bowl. Add sugar. You can also use piloncillo, but I don't have right now. So I'm going to use sugar, brown sugar, about maybe 1, 2, 3, maybe 4, maybe 5. Yeah, about that much. Sugar and then water. Oh boy, this is empty. And fill it up to the top. Then give it a good stir just to dissolve the sugar. Maybe it's a good idea to taste it. Yeah, I think it needs more, a little bit more sugar. So maybe yeah, maybe that much. All right, so let's taste it. And yeah, much better. Nice. And then we just cover it up with a towel or something. And this is just for protecting it from dust and from flies. And we are going to let it stay here for 3 to 4 days until it ferments. So I'm going to leave it here in a nice warm area. And well, let me pick this up. Oh, this pan is full of oil because I was frying tacos. But yeah, let me clean this up really fast. And then with this, we're going to go outside for this. Yeah, and then with this, we're going to plant it because this will give us another pineapple in a couple of years, maybe months. So yeah, I'm still having this problem with the ants. Those holes, they are not coming from there anymore, but now they are coming. Hey cat, they're coming from here. So I also added some cocaine over there. But yeah, I think what I'm going to do is to add a little wall around the tree to protect them, maybe with some insecticide. But now we are going to plant that pineapple. First, I'm going to clean a little bit over here. That will be enough. And now I'm going to plant this papaya near, between this jaboticabo and that papaya. And the reason for planting it here is because we are in a place where water is kind of scarce. So if I plant the plants together, I need to use less water for each one because the water will be shared between the plants. Or instead of watering all the garden, I just need to add water in this place. Yeah. And with this pineapple, we are going to remove the bottom leaves. So let me do that. Just like that, so the stem is a little bit exposed. And then we just place it here and cover it up with dirt. And don't forget to add water. As you can see, I have another pineapple here beneath this macadamia tree, and besides this dragon fruit plant. And also I have another pineapple here. It's a bigger one. However, I think it needs a little bit more water. Yeah. And to protect my tree from the ants, I'm going to place some bricks to protect it. Just like so. Let's see if it helps. And I'm going to add a little bit of insecticide, of venom, over there in the corners, so the ants don't pass through here. And this has helped with me before. You see over there, I have a lemon tree besides those cherry tomatoes, and it has also bricks at the base, and that's helping him. Yeah. Oh, and don't forget to add water to that bastard, eh? Otherwise it's gonna die. Yeah, look at this bougainvillea. Fucking ants. Alright, so this thing has been fermenting for a couple of days. Let's see if it's ready. Oh yeah, it's looking nice. Let's taste it. Oh yeah, it's ready. Okay, so then the only thing we need to do is to strain it. Yeah, like that. Throw the peels into the compost pile. And these are the Thepache. Now we need to keep this in the fridge, otherwise it's going to spoil. Okay? And when you drink it, you need to drink it really cold. We stay.